In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a dynamic map which shows any KPI that you want by geography for a specific company, division, or product. So basically, we're going to be adding interactivity to the map. Let's set this up from scratch. This is my small sample data. I have information on three different divisions: utility, productivity, and game. I'm showing revenue by these regions. I want to visualize this on a map, and I want to do it in a dynamic way so that I can switch my view between these three different divisions and then see the revenue associated with that region. The technique that I'm going to use here is very simple, and you can apply it no matter what type of regions or countries that you're going to show. So you need to follow basically the same technique, just change things up a bit so that it matches the geographical locations that you want to show. Now, that technique is to use a scatterplot with a background image. And later, we're going to switch that scatterplot to a bubble chart. Because bubble chart is basically a scatterplot with an additional dimension. So remember, a scatterplot has values on the X and the Y axis. And those are what we're going to use to find out the position of North America, South America, and so on the map, right? Because right now, revenue is not going to help us with the position of where North America is sitting on this background image, right? So that's something that we need to set up once. Now, obviously, depending on the number of regions that you want to show or the number of countries that you have, you're going to have more work because you need to do that setup once at the beginning. Once you do the work, you can actually use that as your own template and then show any KPI that you want to show on the map. First off, what I'm going to do is to insert a blank scatter plot. So I'm not going to click anywhere on this data set. I'm just going to click outside the data set and insert a scatter plot. Now, the reason I'm doing that is because right now I don't have any values for my X and Y axis. I just have the revenue, which is going to be the size of my bubble, but I haven't defined the location of these. And I'd rather first see the type of map that I'm going to be using or choose that map and then decide on the X and Y values for each of these regions. To find a map, you can double click here, activate the fill options, but we don't want a color, we want to use a picture. You could already have a picture in the company that you can use, so you could click on file and select that picture. You could copy paste it from the clipboard, or you can look online for it. So I'm actually going to test this option and look for something online. For the Bing image search, let's put vector map, and I want a world map, and I want it to be blue. So let's see if we have anything available there. So you can see by default, it looks for Creative Commons only. This means that you can use it for private and commercial purposes, but it doesn't always mean that it's fully free. So sometimes you do have to provide attribution. Now, that's something that you should definitely make sure that you check if you need to provide attribution or not. So which category in Creative Commons it falls under. So let's just see if we see anything. Now, that's the one I'm going to choose. And this one belongs to the public domain pictures. So if I open this, here I can see the license is public domain, so let's just open this in a new window. And this basically means that you do not need to provide attribution, that the person has given up their rights, that they provided this image to the public domain. So, but always make sure that you do check this, and if you do need to provide attribution, you do put it somewhere below your image. For now, I'm going to choose this. I'm going to insert. Now, let me just go and remove my grid lines first and expand this to what I want. Now, you can see This is expandable in any direction, and I don't want to screw this picture, so I'm going to press Ctrl Z and go to the options, and for the size, I'm going to lock the aspect ratio. Also under properties, I'm going to click Don't Move or Size with Cells. Now I'm also going to go and remove the outline here. Another thing I want to do is just stands out too much. So I wanted to provide the idea, I mean, everyone can see that that's a geography, but I want my data set, my revenue to basically stand out and not the image. So I'm going to increase the transparency to something like this. Next step is to plot the points where I have the region sitting on this map. The way I do that is to fix my axis to a certain value set. You can choose, for example, between 0 to 1 for the x and the y axis, or 0 to 10, 0 to 100. So any data set that you'd like to work with, you can select. In my case, I'm going to stick to 0 to 10 scale. And I do need a data preparation table because I'm adding this additional information to the chart. So the data that's going to go in the chart, it's going to be sitting in the data preparation table and not directly in my raw data. Okay, so this data is going to feed this and this is going to feed this. Now I need X and Y information. Basically for each of these regions, okay, let's bring the header as well. I need to say what is the x-axis and what is the y-axis. Okay, so that's x, y, and plot a point here. Now, as a first step, I'm just going to take a guess at where they could be on here. And later, once I add them, I'm going to fix the axis and I can correct these points. So first off, let's do North America. North America is somewhere here. X could be 2 here and y could be 8. Okay, so if I'm restricting mine from 0 to 10, that could be an 8 and 2 on the x-axis. Okay, so this is the upfront work that you need to do once to basically create your template. Second is South America, so that's going to be somewhere here. That could be a 3, and for the y, that could also be a 3. Okay, so I'm going to do the same thing for the other ones. Now that I have some sort of sample data available, I'm going to add this in the chart. So I'm just going to right mouse click, select data, add. So series name, that's basically my locations, and my x-axis are these, and the y are these. Okay, so that's not bad for a starter, and Excel automatically has defined the X and the Y. It's close to what I want, but best is that you fix it, okay, so that they don't shift. So for the axis options, I'm going to fix it to 0 so that it's not auto, but when you see the reset, it means that you really fixed it. I'm going to do the same for the Y axis. Okay, so now that it's fixed, I'm going to remove the chart elements that I don't want visible in the chart. I'm also going to remove this one and remove the grid lines. Okay, so at this stage, I can correct these if I see that they're not on the right place. So for example, for North America, I want it to be a little bit over here. So I'm going to change that to 1.5. For this one, South America, let's just change that a little bit around 2.6 and 3.5. This looks fine. Europe looks fine. This one for Australia, let's just bring it up a little bit. Okay, so that looks better. Now that I have my points where my regions are sitting on this map, I can start to add my third dimension, which is revenue. But my third dimension here is going to be dependent on the division. I want to add a drop-down box for that. So somewhere here, I need the user to select the division, and that's going to be a data validation. Now, if you have these in separate Excel cells that you maybe also convert to a table. If you're adding new divisions to it, you would just reference those cells. But because, let's say in this case, the divisions are not changing, I'm just going to type them in. Okay, you just have to make sure that you type the identical wording of your divisions. But that looks fine. Let's just update the formatting slightly. Now, what we want to do is to get the revenue for the division that the user selects from this drop-down box. Here, let's check how many criteria we have. One criteria is this division. Another criteria is the region. The formula that I'm going to use here is going to be the sum if s formula. And the reason I'm going to use it is because it can handle different criteria. I'm not summing anything up. I'm basically returning one number because that's unique in this case. And North America utility is unique. I don't need to sum it up with other ones, but that doesn't matter. The fact that it allows me to handle different criteria just makes my life much simpler. So the sum range here is this one. I'm going to fix it with the F4 key. One of my criteria is the region, but the second argument here is criteria range. So it's not the criteria itself, but the range where this is sitting on. And that range is here. So I'm going to press F4 to fix it. Now, where is the criteria? What should it look for? Is this one? In this case, I don't need to fix it because I'm just dragging it down. The second criteria is where this one is sitting, and that's here. Again, F4. Now, the criteria itself is this one, and I do want to fix it. For utility, that's this number. That looks good. And now let's see if I typed in the other labels correctly. Productivity and game. Australia, game, that's this number. Okay, so that looks good. Now that I have my revenue in a dynamic way here, and the data preparation table is basically changing based on the selection, all I need to do is to add this in my chart. But where do I add it? Well, first I have to change the chart type from a scatter plot to a bubble chart, because that's going to give me an extra dimension where I'm going to bring in the revenue. Okay, so we're going to go with this one. Now, Excel might be a bit confused about where to put what because it has added a new dimension there. So if I go back to select data and edit this, you can see that it has removed my X values. So I'm just going to add them back in here. My Y values are fine. And this is the extra dimension. And that bubble size is going to be these numbers. Okay, I'm also going to change the series name to basically, let's call it revenue by location. Okay, so that's fine. Now, in the bubble chart, you have different options here. So you can have the size, so basically this, to be either the area or the width. Okay, so I'm going to go with area, but you can also scale it. So if this seems too big on my graph, I can scale it to a smaller size. So I'm going to go with 80 in this case. What I also want to do here is to add the data labels, but these are not the labels I want to show. What are these ones? They're my Y values here, right? So let's go and check our options for labels. That's the Y. I don't want to show the Y. I want to show the bubble size because that's my revenue. Now let's put it. In this case, I'm going to put it center and just change the formatting so that we can see them better. It would be great to have the 1000 separator in there. So that's the number formatting. And by default, it's linked to source. Basically, if I change the formatting here, it's going to show in my charts. I just press Control 1 to go directly to this formatting. Now I can go to custom and click this one. You can obviously also go to number and just activate the 1000 separator. Okay, so that shows up here. So if I switch between game to utility, you can see that the bubbles change and the numbers change. Which is the biggest number here? That's this one for utility. Now for game,
That's Australia. Keep in mind, this is just sample data. Since these numbers are quite close together, it'll be great if I highlight the maximum bubble so that it's easier for anyone to tell, okay, who's the best in terms of utility and who's the best in terms of productivity without looking at the numbers and the size of this bubble. So now the trick is, anything that you want to conditionally format in your charts, you need to add a new series. You can call it anything you want. I'm just going to call it max revenue. Okay, so that's basically a series that I'm going to add there that only shows the number if it is the maximum in this data set. So that series is going to have, in this case, no number, no number, no number, number, no number. That means I could use a combination of the if function and the max formula to get this done. So if this number equals the max of this data set, now I have to fix that, then show this number, otherwise show nothing. It's only showing the number where it comes across the maximum of that data set. So if I switch to utility, now it's this number. Okay, so this entire series only has one number. And this is something I'm going to add to the chart. So right mouse click, go to select data, add, series name, always give your series a name. Now X is the same, Y is the same. The size of the bubble is now my new series right here. Okay, and you can see it already added it in. So now immediately I can see the region that sold the most. So that's how you can create a dynamic map that is controlled by a dropdown, and you can also conditionally format that map to highlight the country or the region you had the most sales in. If you like these type of videos, don't forget to subscribe to my channel so you get notifications when new videos like this one come out.